is my home, Bacchus Marsh. I'm proud to live here. Let me show you around. Come on. The Avenue of Honour is a gateway to Bacchus Marsh and is world famous. At 2:45 p.m. on August the 10th, 1918, at the sound of a military bugle, 281 Canadian L-shells were planted by the town people to commemorate those who served in the First World War.
He left behind his girl, joined up to see the world, and made his mother sad. He made it through the war, came back to town.
Bacchus Marsh is well known for its fresh fruits and vegetables. We are one of the biggest growers in Australia.
And everybody called him the answer.
We have many orchards.
That's still what they call him now.
This is our chicory roasting kiln, built in 1885, and it's still standing. It still has an ad on the side, painted on. It's advertisement for Dr. Marsh Indian Root Pills. They cleanse your blood. Check out this huge tree behind me. It is hundreds of years old. This tree was used for the reference of the town planning. This is Madeline Park. Let's go in. We have lots of sporting activities like netball, cricket, and footy.
There were times he thought he'd been forgotten.
We also have lawn tennis courts that are hundreds of years old.
They stand for that man they call the Anzac. And those who gave their lives for us, they stand for
the best Aussie service station in the world. It has delicious food, great service. This is Bacchus Marsh College. This is where I go to school. My dad went to this school, but his dad didn't go to this school. This is the Werribee River. We have two rivers in Bacchus Marsh. This is the Werribee River Dam Wall.
At the same time every year, we all remember him. At the crack of dawn, we stand as one for all our fallen friends. So dream.
And this is our other river, the Lady Dirk River. And as you see right now, it's dry. Except that part of
so
right there. This is the skate park. I love coming here. Captain William Henry Bacchus, a retired military officer and judge, took up land in the valley between the Werribee and Lady Dirk rivers. The town was named after Captain Bacchus and after the natural marshland. He discovered Bacchus Marsh. This is his grave. He died on 24th February 1849, aged 67. Bacchus Marsh is on the edge of the Wombat State Forest. There's so much you can do in the Wombat State Forest. Bushwalking, four-wheel driving, sightseeing, looking at mines, motorbike riding, horse riding. This is Darley Park, home of the Darley Devils. Go Devils!
Hey!
This is me, mate, Chum.
Now I'm free to breathe my breath. Take time out to let go of all the beliefs that I've been told. And now I'm free to breathe my breath. My own breath.
This is known as Bald Hill. It's not very bald anymore because it's got trees, which is classed as hair. A lot of Bald Hill is very volcanic.
Your feelings on earth.
I'll show you my special rock. This is my special rock.
I'll take some time out.
Got me a name cut in here.
Feel it, so let it go.
This would have to be one of the best views to see Bacchus Marsh. You can see. It's a real good view.
And you will be free to breathe your breath, your own breath.
Thanks for watching! How am I gonna get down?